This conference will now be recorded.
All right, friends. So today is day 12. And last time we saw ECL's access control list. And we saw about the crude operations, read, write, delete, right? Create. We saw examples. We created a table name, TestJC, I believe. This was our table. We did some R&D, we tried to ensure fields, which we were able to do successfully. Then towards the end of the session, there was a question, how to hide records? And we didn't have a proper scenario for that, right? So if this is a table and it contains n number of records, I want to hide certain records based on certain criteria from users. This is our dummy table. I will go back to our table, which is, let me change the application scope. Ours was Propnil application, right? Let us do something on that. We didn't do anything on the table. I will delete the ECLs and then we will see. This is our inventory table. Let us see what all ACLs does it have. It must be having the out of the box 4 ACLs expected because we didn't do anything over here. Go to the middle tab, controls. This one. Scroll down, out of the box ACLs. What does it have? If I open randomly any one, it must be having the system role, the default role created for this table. Let me check, see. This is the role created automatically when this table was created. Where do we find this role? You know that. So a quick brush up, the default role for the table, we can find it over here. Maybe in the same tab, this is the user role. Whenever a new table gets created in ServiceNow, the system will create 4 default ACLs. Those 4 ACLs will have this default role. That means in each of the ACL, this role will be configured. So if I want to give a particular user whole access, create, read, write, delete, I'll open the user profile. I will configure this highlighted role. By giving this single role, the user will be able to do each and everything with the table. Why? Because the role is common across all the 4 ACLs. Like if I open this, this is how the default setting is. See, same role. That same role is there in each of the ACL. Okay, now let us try to do some tampering with the ACLs. So let us delete it. To delete the ACL, select them from here and grayed out. Now, anyone from you, can you suggest why this is so? What I have to do?
You have to elevate the roles. Okay.
Correct. So I'll go here, elevate. To play around with the ACLs, one should elevate the role. Interview question, security underscore admin. Role needs to be given. When the user logs out, this role will be removed automatically from the session. So when the user is back again, the user will have to elevate the privileges. Now, Let us delete. We don't want this system is here. But if you want, you can play around with this. Even you can modify these ACLs. Okay. If you have elevated the privileges, you can open one of the ACL, you can change the role. But this is something we are going to create our own new ACL. We want to create a read ACL such that the user should be able to read some filtered records. Let us see. All right, not a single ACL is there on this table now. So even though the person has got this role, the person won't be able to do anything. Nothing is here. The person won't be able to access anything, I believe, right? Okay. So first of all, let us open a duplicate tab. I'll close this. Duplicate tab. I want to show you how our table looks. So we can design a use case around it. We also have a status field. Let us try to do something with that. Status. Bring it up somewhere here. Approved, approved. Let this be as rejected or proposed or anything. See, regardless of the ACLs, whether they exist or doesn't exist, why I am able to read all these records? Just because I am an administrator. Remember this. Expired. And then this one. Rejected. Now we have a good use case. You'll be able to relieve. What is this? Data policy exception. Rejection. See. Okay. Let us disable the data policy, or let us do anything. Rejection reason. Do we have anything like that? If you remember, we built a validation. If the status is rejected, we have to fill this up, right? So even the form was not open. See, a good example of data policy, which is similar to UI policy, but not exactly the same as UI policy. UI policy needs the form to be visible, right? The user should do something with the field, and then it will be like I did on cell edit, even though it throwed the error, right? So now, sample, let it be like this. Our main focus is on status. So now let us build a use case. The user should be the user having read permission on this table should view only those records which are in approved state. Again, the user having read ACL permission should be able to see only those records where the status is approved. Rest of the records are of no use for that user. Can we do this thing? Let us try. So let us create a new ACL. Today we won't be creating the rest of the ACLs. Our focus is on read ACL. Okay, rest of the things remain as the same. So read. Okay. Now, none means table level. Okay. Let us create a new role. We haven't created any role for this, right? And we don't want to use that system role. Let it be like that. So I'll go to roles, create a new role. See, that day we created so many roles, right? Now, ours is Swapnil application. Swapnil read. Okay. Submit. A new role is created. Copy. I'll come to the ACL. Our role and save. Continue. We have an ACL, table level ACL, read ACL, and the one who has got this role in the user profile or any group to which we give this role, all the members in that group should be able to read, only read the records from this table. Let us confirm. I'll take a user, Control C. I'll go to users table. Last time, what was the user? I don't remember. Believe it was Kalyani. Let us remove all of our roles. She has got so many. Okay. Doesn't matter. We know that she cannot access Swapnil application, right? Impersonate as Kalyani and just confirm if she already has access to the table or not, because we don't know. We did a lot of R&D with the roles. Like now this is Kalyani. See, she already has roles. Now, when we did this few sessions back, she was able to read. But now, as I said, we deleted the ACLs. That's the reason why she is not able to. Right? The ACL is there, does exist for read, but the role configured in that ACL is not configured in Kalyani's profile. That's the reason she is facing these things, this error. Okay. So now, go to her profile. Users. Kalyani. Give her that role. Go to edit our newly created role. Edit, paste, hit enter, shortlisted, given. Let us remove, we don't want this. Though there is no harm keeping them, but let's not have them. Okay. Profile modified. Now she has this role. We don't even want this. Remove. All right. SNC internal is the default role when a user profile is created. This is the role we created. We configured it in the ACL. We give the same role to Kalyani, expecting her to have read-only access to the table. So it's done. Let us see if she can see the records. Impersonate I doubt if she will be able to see. What do you think? Any suggestions? ACL rule given. Would she be able to read the record? Yes or no? Swapnil Kalyani, any suggestion? Any answer? Lokesh, Dipali, would Kalyani be able to read the records that we have given the ACL rule, everything? Any guess? No. What is remaining? That one thing. No idea. Okay. I told you that day, even though we give the ACLs and all, there is one thing we have to do is give the access for this menu. This and this, parent and the child. Here, it's not there, right? Kalyani doesn't have this role. We just removed it, the default role, right? Put this role over here as well. Remove this. Where is our role? Search for it. Swapnil read. Done. Anyone having this role in the user profile will be able to see this menu. Simple. Update. Yes. And the child one. Okay, the child was modified. Let us give it to the parent. Remove the default role. See, what did I say? When a new table is created in ServiceNow, four default ACLs are created. They all have a common role. What role? The same role which is present in the controls tab in the user role field. And that particular role by default will be present over here as well for the new table in the navigation menu. When you click on this pencil icon, edit icon, you will see the same role over here. That's why I was saying anyone with the default role will be able to access the table in the menu item and will be able to perform all the operations for that table. It's a kind of shortcut. One role can do anything with that table. Access menu item, read, write, create, delete, everything, which we don't want over here. Remove. Now search for our role, Swapnil read. It is this. Give it. Done. So now can Kalyani see the records? She should be able to now. Yes. Yes, all the records. Where is status? In her view, it is not configured. In admin has configured its own view. Let us. So as Kalyani, I am configuring my list layout. Bring it up. List layout differs from user to user because the default layout can be overwritten. So now you will say, like Pankaj, she is able to see the records, agreed. But then our use case is to show only those records which are in approved status. Now, go back, log out, end impersonation. Yeah. Elevate, already elevated? Don't think so. Yes, it is already elevated. Because we didn't log out. Go to the ACL. ACL. I can navigate to the ACL from here as well. I told you last time, right? We just have a single ACL. So I think using a wildcard. Do we have Swapnil Reed? I am not able to see. I am not sure. Sorted by updated. The one created today. Old entry. Swapnil F. Say Reed ACL. This is inventory. Ours were different, right? Our was kind of Swapnil Reed. Do you see that? Swapnil child table, Swapnil child table. Inventory. Okay, I think this is the one. Today is as per the instance, it is 30. Today is 31, but instance time zone, it should be this. Because that shows the table name, right? Yeah. This is the one, and this is the role. Correct. Now, this is a table level read ACL, and that day I was trying to show you how to filter out the records, but our scenario was not correct. Now I will give it as this is by default all the records. I want to filter status is approved, done. That means the person with this role should be able to see the records, but conditions apply. Those records where status is approved, ignore rest of the records. Okay, update. Yes, now again login as Kalyani. Kalyani has got that role, but now would she be able to see all the records? Let's see. And done. Anyone having any question? How did we do this? We simply gave a condition to filter out the records. It is the same read ACL. Last session, we didn't give any condition. The only difference is this time we gave a condition. So now there is a scenario where Kalyani should see only two, but say some other user should be able to see all the records. So how to do that? For one user, all the records should be visible. For Kalyani, only approved one should be visible. So how to do that? I will end impersonation. We are back at admin as administrator. I will go to the table. ACLs. Only one ACL. I cannot say new button because we did an impersonation. After that, we logged in. Yes. Now let's play the trick. Before creating this, let us create a new rule. Roles. Swapnil read. Control C. I will create a similar role. Swapnil read all. Something like that. Read all records. Control B. All is the name. Don't get confused. These are different. Okay. Swapnil read all. Now I will copy this. Control C. And then let us search for a user paste this somewhere so that we have it handy. Search for a user. We will have to pick up some random user with which we can do some testing. Not admin Bushra. Bushra.akhtar1 open. She's an admin. We want a non-admin user. Swapnil Joshi, let us see. Non-admin user. I will give him this role. This role has been configured in Swapnil's profile. But then also he won't be able to see anything. Swapnil Joshi, if I impersonate Swapnil, shouldn't be able to see anything only because we just created a role and gave it to him. Does any ACL exist for that role? No. So obviously he won't be able to see anything starting with Swapnil. See, nothing. So now let us go there and create an ACL. What kind of ACL? Again a read ACL. Let us see. Again a read ACL. Elevate. Scroll down. I will create a new read ACL. Let us see if it allows us to create more than one read ACL. Read. Select that role, newly created role. Do we see that role over here? Yes. Such a long name, but let it be. It's a sample data. Ideally, it should be short and simple. Now I am not giving any condition. And this is a table level read ACL. Let me submit it. Now remember, this role is with Swapnil. So does that mean Swapnil should be able to read all the records present in the table? Logically, it means so. But let us try. Impersonate. Where is it? Why? This is Swapnil. Swapnil has got read ACL role or no? We should see, right? What happened? What went wrong? And impersonation. Let us check his profile. What went wrong? Did we give him the correct role? Or something clicks you? You tell me. Swapnil, how many Swapnils are there? Let us check. Otherwise, there will be a confusion. Right click Swapnil. Only one Swapnil is there in the system. What kind of role does he have? This is the role. Swapnil read. This is our table. This is the role name. This is the suffix. The role is good. And then, yes, this role means table level. Okay. Now tell me, where do we go wrong? Anyone smart enough to guess? No idea. Okay. The same thing happened. Everything is there. But how about accessing this in the menu item? Who can access Swapnil application in the navigation? The one, only the one who has got this role. Correct. This role. Does Swapnil have this role? No. So let us add one more role over here. Where is that? X underscore. We will have to search it carefully. Vedika Swapnil. First table, it is this. How do we know? It's the same, right? It was a big name. So, Swapnil AP. Let us do it as done. Read all, correct. This role, update. And over here in the parent, not here. Click on this, done. Click on this remaining. Select the same role. Yeah. Remember, if we give this role to Swapnil, then he'll be able to see only those approved records, which we don't want. We want him to have the privilege to read all the records. forget about the record. The question is about the navigation items. Correct. I could have given this role to Swapnil. Sorry, yes, to Swapnil, right? Swapnil Joshi, I mean. But then, where is that? Inventory. No. Name the patients. Swapnil inventory. PQRS. Let me know once you see the role. It is this. All right. I will update this. So either a person has this role in the user profile or this role. Any one role out of these, a person will be able to see the navigation menu. Makes sense, right? Now, let us log in as Swapnil and see what he can view on the table. And wow, all the records. Kalyan is able to see only approved ones, and this champ can view everything approved, rejected. Why? Because we have created the ACL like that. That one person should be able to see this. Excuse me, I'm getting a call. Yeah, so yes, this is how we filter out the records user to user. So if there are more users, create groups and do the same thing with groups. Give role to the group and the same role in the ACL. Correct. Anyone having confusion how to filter out the records based on the roles, based on ACLs? We have created two read ACLs on the table. One is having role one, other one is having role two. Role one has got a qualification, role two doesn't have any qualification. That's the reason if we give read role one to any user, not just Kalyani, it can be any user, any other user. Whoever has that role will be able to see only the approved records. The one having role two will be able to see all the records. Swapnil, understood. Kalyani, Lokesh, Dipali.
Yes, Pankaj.
All right. Do some practice, okay? And you will be through. Now I want to. Yes.
One question. So this is about the custom form we have created. What about the incident and change? I mean, like we have company level restrictions. If two different users are there, so one user won't be able to see the records for other company. So how this is controlled in your the multi-tenancy part?
Yeah, see, we did one thing, query business rule, correct? Two sessions back, right? Query business rule. That is one of the way to achieve that. We did. Let me show you the query business rule. There are many ways. Okay. One of the way is this query business rule. I will tell you. Okay. This is software. That's the reason. Thank you. query business rule on incident table on before. See, what did this do? If the user who has currently logged in is present in the caller field, or if not that, if the person is present in the assignment group, show the incident to that user. If one of the condition matches, then also show. If both of this condition match, then also show. If both of this fail, then don't show the incident to the user. So can't you implement a similar logic on incident table? The incident table must be having company or something. Let's see. It must be having some hidden fields. Open an incident. Go to this. At least in the view, does it have department or company? Department not there. Company. In the view, it is not there, right? See, company equal to something, and then dynamic something. Current dot update. This is one of the way. Include company in the qualification, right? Or using ACLs. See, this is one of the way, interview question. How many ways are there to implement multi-tenancy? You can say, you know, two ways. One is using a query business rule. We can play around with the query and hide show the incident from a user based on company field. Or it can also be achieved smartly using ACLs. Correct. So when we say ACL, close, we will configure the foundation data. When I say foundation data, users comes first, foundation, all the users, regardless of what customer they support. See, multi-tenancy, what does it mean? This is my ServiceNow instance. This is my ServiceNow instance. There can be hundreds or thousands or lakhs of users in the sys underscore user table, which is this users table. 50% of the users support customer C1. They resolve their tickets. Customer C1 ticket comes in. 50% of the users out of these work on those tickets. They should be able to see only those tickets. Rest of the 50% of the users, maybe lower chunk, work on customer C2 tickets. Whenever customer C2 creates any ticket, these people will work on it. Now, the lower chunk, that is 50%, should not be able to see the tickets related to rest of the users. That is customer C1 tickets, customer C1, customer C2. C1 is a company configured in ServiceNow. C2 is a company configured in ServiceNow. So we will give role R1 to 50% of the users, role R2 to rest of the 50%, R1 and R2. I will create two read ACLs like I created just now. And in the qualification, I will write company equal to C1. And in the other read ACL, I will give company equal to C2. Same scenario that we did just a few minutes back. In their profiles, or first 50 users, put it in group 1. Rest of the 50 users, put it in group G2. Give role R1 to group G1, so that there is no need to give individually that single role to each user, correct? Give role R2 to group G2. Job is done. Create two read ACLs. Give R1 to first ACL, R2 to second ACL, and then you will see the magic. Criteria, give that criteria, whatever I showed, how to filter the records. Company equal to this, company equal to that, or assignment group equal to this, assignment group equal to that. Not just company, you can build a criteria like that, right? Like these people should be able to see incidents, only assignment group equal to something, change management, or assignment group equal to this, that. You can build a qualification. This is how we do data segregation. They would be able to see each other's record, what we see, saw just now. Same thing can be done in incident management. There is a third way as well. So that is something we won't be able to see this on the instance because that's a kind of paid plugin. There is something called domain separation. I'll show you the theory part of that. So usually you won't be doing that in companies because when the foundation is laid, the ServiceNow people itself configure that. But I'll show you a way like how domain separation can be achieved. So at least in the interview, you will be able to say something. Actually, there are three ways to do data segregation. One, query business rule. Second, using ACLs, the way I just told you. Third is domain separation. That is a paid plugin. If we don't have enough budget to use the paid plugin, then go ahead with a query business rule or ACL. Okay, when to use query business rule? When there is not much of heavy lifting. Because query business rule invite performance issues. When we click on the left hand side, it will load the data. Before loading, it will trigger a query. If the query is complex, it will result in performance issue. The form will hang before showing the data. Getting it real time issues. Lightweight, go for it. Okay. Smart people do it through ACL. Best use ACL is only because people don't know how to create, when to use, how to use, where to use ACLs, they create a query business rule. Otherwise, the best thing, go ahead with, if there is heavy lifting, you want to check a lot of things, right? Go through, follow ACL approach. Getting? So is that question answered? You can try it out for incidents. You can try it.
Yeah.
Right? Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I want to show you something interesting. It's been quite some time we did into scripting. Again, scripting coming back. So now I have a real-time scenario. My manager has told me to auto-close incidents that are 1 week old. Last week since today. Last week up till today, only those incidents which are on hold. No progress. They are on hold. I want to auto close such incidents. Okay. I want to write a scheduled job. I don't want to do it manually. Okay. Manually, if I go over here, if there are 400 to 500 incidents. Where did it go? There are many incidents over here. On daily basis, the volume is such higher in real-time scenario. Thousands of incidents get reported. How will I find out one by one, which is on hold? Even if I do like this, right click on hold. It will show me all the incidents in the system which are on hold. But how about the date criteria and all? A kind of mess. I will have to build a complex qualification and this and that. ServiceNow simplifies this. How? In the very first session, if you remember, I showed you how to build a qualification funnel. Funnel. Let us do all. So now we see all these incidents, regardless of the state and all. So If I click on this, let us filter. State is on hold. But along with it, the incidents created last week up till now. So that means this condition should match. Along with that, one more condition should also match. Both of these should match, otherwise no. Create date. Created means created date. Okay. Created date between this that I used one. Sometime back, let me check. Between last week and today. Okay. Between. See, you can give so many things. You can give a range between today and between last week and today. Last week, next week, hundreds of options possible for you to filter the data. Okay. Now, does it look this like this? State is on hold and created between last week and today. Between last week and today. Shall I run this qualification? Let's see how many are such incidents that are created last week. Okay. This is something I created today in the morning, just as a sample incident so that I can show you the result of the search. Okay. There can be hundreds of such incidents which are on hold, created last week, right? Or today. Today's incident will also be included. But what is our job? To auto close this automatically based on some scheduled job. The heart of the script would be the query. Rest of the things we know, even in the UI action, we saw how to auto close child incidents. Click on a button. On click of a button, we close the child incident. So closing the incidents, we know what to fulfill. Close notes, close code, status equal to 7, we know that. But what incident to close? Do we have a query? No. Now see the magic. Hover. Once you run the filter, the results are displayed. Just hover, right click, copy query. Paste the query. Control V. Ready-made query, which we can use in our Glide records server side script. Okay. State on hold, created between, why it is 19th of July. Let's see. Last week indeed means Monday, 19th of July, correct? Up till today, 31st. Last week means last week's Monday. Up till today, exactly. We have copied that query. We have pasted it over here. All right. And now, we should trigger that again. Let's see. I'm just worried about the three present in this encoded query. Status is on hold. And created date is between last week
and today run. Now right click, copy query and paste. Yep, we are good. Okay, so now where is the code? This is the code. Bring it over here in the down Google. Control X, Control V. I can write this code in a scheduled job. While rs.next, do this, do that. But I want to write a query to do anything with incident table. I should open a glide reference to the table. I should have a query where gr equal to new glide record. We know this incident. Open a reference to incident table. Okay. And then how about encoded query? Gr dot, there is a syntax glide encoded query. Let me check. See, gr dot add encoded query. Let me copy this whole. Control C. Control V. Add encoded query allows us to put the query we have constructed or we have copied from the incident table. Where is our query? Ours is lying over here. Control C, put it in between single quotes. Control V. This is our query. Between begin of last week, this, that, and then finally query. So it will query the incidents as per this encoded string and then check. While gr.next, go to the first record, put its close code equal to solve permanently. This is same as what we did in the UI action. By closing, we have to give this mandatory fields. Usually we give it in the UI, but as we are doing this from the back end, we will have to give it, right? Closing through scheduled job notes. State equal to 7 means for incident it is closed, and then update the incident. That's it. Copy our chunk. Control C. Where to put this is the question. Code is ready, boss. Where to put this to run it automatically? Schedule jobs. Create a new schedule job. Automatically run a script of your choosing. Give the name to the job. So apnil auto close. Okay. Any meaningful name. It will run daily. So let's say every 3 minutes. Hours, minutes, seconds. If I give hour, it will run, but we have no time to wait for an hour. That's why I am giving 3 minutes. I will paste my script over here. How does it look? Let's see. It will start with opening and reference to incident table. Usually we give gr.add query when the query is very simple, like gr.add query status active will give me all the active incidents which are open. Our query was complex, so we went to the incident table, we filtered out the incidents, we copied the encoded query, we paste it over here. Finally, gr.query will execute this encoded query, then traverse to each record. If there are n number of records, go to each record, take the first one, close it, again go second, close it, whatever. In our case, the result is just one. We just have one. Let us create one more, then we will see. But then let us keep this inactive, otherwise it will immediately run in 3 minutes. We want to create sample incident. That's the only reason why I am disabling this, otherwise it will start running. Now incident, create new. INC2 caller and even submit. Okay, but that has to be on hold, correct? INC2. Let us update it straight from here. If we can do it, I doubt because the scope is different. We can do it. So on hold happened, and let us create one more so that we have three created today. INC3 created by an event constructor. Status on hold, submit. On hold reason, awaiting caller. Now if we trigger our query like state and created between last week till today. Last week till today. Yes. If I run this, it shows three incidents on hold status. See, this is how it filtered out. So that means when we run this job, all these three incidents should have a state as closed. This is what we are trying to do now. So let us activate this. I will keep it as 2 minutes. 2 minutes is good enough. Then set it as active. It's 11:08. In 2 minutes, it will run. From here, I can refresh the list to check if the state changes. Not yet. Encoded string. If you see, it constructs by itself everything. JavaScript, js.end of today. It has all of its standard libraries functions. We don't have to worry much about it. System will take care of it. It builds, see, it's created on, what does that mean? It is created, the field which has the label as created, that is the field we selected in the qualification, right? And between, beginning of, last week, these all are functions. How do they call the functions? Glide system object, GS dot. See the use of GS dot, right? What happened with this? Did it get closed? Refresh. No. 2 minutes have passed, I think. We will have to troubleshoot. If it has not closed them, we will have to check. We will wait for 1 minute more. Did we do anything wrong over here? State equal to 3, that means on hold. This is end condition and the second condition over here. This is created between this type, right? And then, yes, we triggered the query. We traverse through each record and then we updated it. So where the problem is, every 2 minutes. Did you see the mistake? Periodically. We need to be careful, right? Save. Now see. It is 12 past 11. Now let us start counting. By 12, 13, 14. 14 past 11, it should close all these incidents. If we haven't done any other mistake, it should close. Do we have full strength today? We have very less people, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Is Swapnil left? Where did he go? He was there, I believe. Might be some deployment or something. So Swaraj is there, Dipali is there, Lokesh. Vedika is missing and Swapnil is missing, right? Let us refresh. Gone. Worked. Why it is gone from the list? Because it no more matches the qualification. Now, why it no more matches the qualification? Qualification says show on hold records that are created between last week and today. But our code changed from on hold, changed the state from on hold to closed. Let us check. Where is the proof that they have been modified? Active equal to true. They won't be listed over here because whenever we click on open incident, by default, the system will only show the records matching active equal to true qualification. So go to all. See our incidents, INC3, INC2, and YY. Closed, closed, closed. Modified date. Do we have updated by updated date? And let us also select updated by, just out of curiosity, I want to check. Updated by should be system or something. Sort. Updated by administrator. These have been updated. Most recent updated records. Closed by our automated code. Then if it is like this, you can play around with this. There are hundreds of qualifications that you can build. ServiceNow gives us so much. Play around. See? Greater than, less than, is empty, this, that. You can do anything and copy the query the way I showed you. And then use it over here. This is how you create a scheduled job. Anyone who didn't understand this scripting, we saw server-side scripting in a scheduled job. We saw server-side scripting in a UI action. We saw server-side script in business rule. Correct? There are so many places where we can write server-side scripts. Whenever we deal with glide record, that means we are doing server-side script. Whenever we are using GS dot, that means we are using server-side script. In client script, we never use GS dot. That's a client script. We use G underscore form over there. G underscore form dot get value, set value, whatever it is. Here we do GS dot get value, set value. Correct. We use server-side script in glide ajax. How? I wrote the server-side script in my script include. So script include is also a place where we can use server-side script. We saw so many things so far, right? This is how it is. Okay. So any query around this? Otherwise, we will proceed. Okay. Or shall we do one thing? Today, I think Vedika is not there. I don't want her to lose a big portion. Okay. We can continue tomorrow and I'll start a brand new topic called catalog. So that she will also be here and we all can do it together. What do you say? Can we stop here today?
Okay, Bambaja, fine.
Yes. So make sure you go through this video as well. We studied two important things today. How to hide, see, last session we saw how to hide show fields, right? Today we saw how to hide records from users. We also talked about the ways to achieve multi-tenancy. We saw how to run a scheduled job. We saw the script. Try this out. Okay. And let's meet tomorrow. We will start with catalog. Catalog items, record producer. Okay, that is the main part. And after that, a very, very important part is integration. These two important topics, big topics are left. After that, we will be doing a kind of mock interviews and all. Okay, I'll prepare you for the interviews. We will see how to build resume. Long way to go. Still, we have many sessions to go. Don't worry about it. Okay, so do some practice. All right, friends, let's meet tomorrow same time. I'll share the recording in the evening. Also, I'll share the link for tomorrow, late evening. Okay. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Bye.
Thank you. Okay.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah.